In this video, we're going to talk about the High Tide Manufacturing Powder. This is a board that has elongated tip and tail kicks with a minimal camber to allow you to catch air in the backcountry or even in the resort. It's a powder freestyle board that can stomp, but still handle ripping a groomer and carving. This board features traditional camber, which is what High Tide utilizes across their board line. It's a very mellow traditional camber, so you have 3 to 4 millimeters in there, so it's easy to engage, but it's still gonna have that snap and pop of traditional camber. This board is only available in regular sizes. The Powder features one of those true old school directional flex. Softer in the nose, stiffest in the tail. It just progressively stiffens up through there. There's a moderate amount of torsional flex, but not an overabundance. And this is a board that if you ever wanted to run over stuff and be unscathed, this is it. That's just it. It plows through everything. There's no chatter. It's damp. This board just absorbs everything in its path as you go over it. High speeds, you're never going to feel those micro vibrations. You never have to worry about it. It just does what you need it to do. It's great. This is just a board for charging hard and not giving a fuck. This isn't the snappiest board I've been on. It's actually a pretty moderately okay board at popping. It doesn't matter how aggressively you load up the camber on this, you're still going to get the same response. This board is just very dependent on how hard the rider engages it to pop with it. If you want to butter with this board, forget about the tail, it's just not going to happen. Concentrate all your efforts on the nose, getting your weight over it, really aggressively pressing into it, just making sure that you can find the flex point and drive the board. And even then, you're not going to get a deep butter out of it. You're going to get one of those quick ones that reverts around and then you go on with your way. This board is smooth and stable when you're on edge. You never have to worry about it just washing out or buckling. This is a board that it's not the most friendly for Euro carving. You're gonna notice that right away, that it just doesn't let you aggressively drive and get low and drop your elbow on the snow. This is a board that's gonna say no to you if you try to Euro carve. It's gonna be like, no, fuck you, not doing it. And you're gonna be like, okay, well, all right, let's go just do a long drawn out carve from one end of the trail to the other. And it's gonna be like, okay, that's what I like to do. That's how this board rides. This board is 100% for that old school, hard charging free ride guy that wants camber and wants to bust through anything in their path. The guy that's just gonna be hauling ass as hard as he can and just ripping around the mountain, doing what he needs to do.
Anyways, without further ado, here's some other decks to look at that compare to the Powder from High Tide. The Libtech Swiss Knife, the Arbor Sin Nombre, the Gnu Mueller, the K2 Joydriver, the Rosinal Crypto.
All right, so now you've decided what snowboard you're gonna get and you're going to decide where you're gonna buy it. If you're shopping local, awesome. Slap your local shop guys a high five and tell them they're killing it. But for those of you that are buying online, why don't you shop from one of the links we have down below? That way you support us and you get a deal on your snowboard.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. That way you can see all the relevant or irrelevant snowboarding content that we're putting out for you guys. So smash that bell down below. That way you're getting a notification. And I'll see you guys in another video.
Say it with me. Powder. 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 It's like French Canadian, which, I mean, I'm wearing a tuxedo hockey jersey. Doesn't get more Canadian than that. And classy.